Surfing Sapo here. Today is March 10th, 2009. Today I'm going to be grilling up some of these. Y'all know what that is? Anybody? Faja belt. Eat the little belts. Fajitas. Beef fajitas. I'm going to be making that out back on the Tuscany grill with some lump charcoal from Kingsford. With a little bit of hickory or pecan, something like that, to give it a little bit of smoky flavor. So let's get started. All right, what I've done here is trimmed up four pieces of fajita meat. I'm fixing to hit them with this hammer, not to tenderize it, but to pop holes in it so that this Suzy Q seasoning that I got from Helen can go in there with some limes. And I just wanted to show you how much fat I've trimmed off there. That's how much fat I trimmed off, so that'll be going to the dogs. Alright, let me go ahead and marinate these and then start the pit and we'll get started. Okay, we've got the charcoal chimney started. I'm not going to let it get all the way to the top. By the time that gets coals get started, the bottom will be out, so I don't want to do it like that. Anyway, just going to dump them in. There you go. See how much is in there? Talking hot fire down there. Let's take a gander at that. They're nice and hot. So let me put on the Tuscany grill. Do this without hitting the tripod. Put on the Tuscany grill. Let that get nice and hot. And then we will commence to grilling. Okay, good news, just put a couple on. They're not very thick, so just lay them on there. Like that, like so. See how that lime juice has already tried to cook the meat? It's tried to cook it. Good. Go ahead and let those start grilling. We'll take a look at them in a minute. Okay, they've been flipped over. One side I put a chunk of pecan in there just to give it a little bit of smoke flavor. Otherwise it's just gonna taste plain, which is good too. Okay, carry on. These coals are great because they get super, super hot. Perfect for grilling. And these are the awesome grilling. They're not for long lasting, quick, short grilling sessions. See that? Take a gander at that. A lot of smoke, kind of hard to see in the video. Believe me, they're good. Okay, here's the last two on, grilling away. They're doing pretty good. Yeah, folks. We've got fajitas. They're kind of resting now. I don't cook them all the way through. I like them a little bit raw or rare for the simple reason if I don't eat all these, when I heat them back up, they'll be perfect. If you cook them perfect right now, when you heat them up, they're going to lose all their juice. They're not going to be too good. So let me get one out there so you can see it. There you go. Let me get that right there. See that? Fajita, Texas style. South Texas style. And the key to fajitas is use a lot of salt. It brings out the fat flavor, the char flavor. And let's cut these up and try them out.
Okay, folks, they're done. What we got here is a fajita taco. See it? Ain't got no salsa, no cheese, meat, and tortilla. That's all. The reason I eat them like that, because I want to taste the meat. I don't want to eat all that other stuff. Why put all that hot stuff in there? You ain't gonna taste the meat. You might as well just put a sponge in there or something. Anyway, that's my opinion. Anyway, let's try it out. Mm-mm. That lime juice and salt is what tightens it up. It's really good. You can do it too. Now let me tell you a secret. It's not a secret, but we all know it down here. But when you eat tortillas, don't just take them out of the bag and put them in the microwave, okay? Get you a cast iron skillet, or if you live in South Texas, comal. Put it on the stove, get it hot, flip them over and toast them. Because they are not cooked when you get them. They might look cooked, they are not cooked. That's just a tip from down here, okay? So anyway, hope you enjoyed the video. God bless you. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye. Thank you.